जम्मू लिंक्स न्यूज टॉप स्टोरीज इज ब्रॉट टू यू बाय तस्या हर्बल्स अल्कोहल बेस्ड हैंड सैनिटाइजर विद नीम एंड एलोवेरा एक्सट्रैक्ट्स हेल्पिंग इंडिया फाइट कोविड-19। Schools here reopened on Monday on a voluntary basis requiring the consent of the parents for students to attend the schools amid the COVID-19 pandemic. Ministry of Home Affairs in its order mentioned that states and UTs may permit up to 50% of teaching and non-teaching staff to be called to schools for online teaching and related works from September 21st. The government has allowed students of class 9th to 12th to visit schools from today on a voluntary basis. Asserting that education is key to success, Jammu and Kashmir Lieutenant Governor Manoj Sinha on Monday said that new education policy 2020 will empower youth and bring landmark change in the Union Territory. Education is the key to success and development. We want to make Jammu and Kashmir the center of knowledge, enterprise, innovation and skill development, Sinha said in his address while speaking at the conference on implementation of new education policy 2020, organized by the University of Jammu in collaboration with Higher Education Department Jammu and Kashmir. The People's Democratic Party on Monday held a meeting of its senior leaders here for the first time since Jammu and Kashmir's special status was revoked by the centre in August last year. The meeting was chaired by party's Vice President Abdul Rahman Aviri in the presence of Party President Mehbooba Mufti, who is under detention at the PDP headquarters, Srinagar. The party held its first meeting post the release of party leaders who were detained in August last year when the centre abrogated Article 370. The meeting was attended by senior leaders of the party, including former ministers and legislators. Jammu Municipal Corporation has installed point of sale terminals in order to promote digital transactions and to give momentum to Digital India initiative of Government of India for collection of birth and death certificates, fee and other revenue collection. It is also planned to install 50 more such kind of POS devices to collect revenue digitally. With the launch of this initiative, GMC employees will get rid of collecting and depositing cash process, resulting into efficient and time-effective governance. Terrorist attacked a road opening party of Central Reserve Police Force at Nogam in the outskirts of Srinagar on Monday. No one was injured. Security forces present in the area also retaliated, but the terrorist managed to escape. This was the second such attack on security forces in Nogam area of the bypass in city outskirts since August 14, when two police personnel were killed and another was injured. Pakistan on Monday violated the ceasefire along the line of control in the Shahpur, Kirni and Kasba sectors of Jammu and Kashmir's Poonch district. Pakistan violated the ceasefire by firing with small arms and intense shelling with mortars at around 2:30 p.m. The Indian Army retaliated befittingly. Pakistan on September 19th violated the ceasefire along the line of control in the Digwar and Malti sectors of Jammu and Kashmir's Poonch district. A day after two contentious farm bills were passed by the Rajya Sabha, dozens of youth Congress activists on Monday staged a protest demonstration in Jammu against the BJP-led central government. Carrying placards and raising slogans against the union government, the protesters led by J&K Youth Congress President Udhay Chib gathered at the exhibition ground in. They also tried to march towards the main road but were stopped and pushed back by the police. Property worth lakhs of rupees has been damaged in a fire incident in downtown area of Srinagar city. Fire broke out at Babdem Khanyar in the downtown late Sunday night. Fire tenders from different parts of the city were rushed to spot to control the leaping flames, which were visible from the entire downtown. Two houses, a bandsaw machine and a shed were damaged in the fire, adding to loss could be worth rupees 60 lakhs. The cause of fire was not known. Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday hailed the passage of the two contentious farm bills in the Rajya Sabha and congratulated all farmers for their passage. He was speaking at a virtual event after inaugurating Ghar Tak Fiber Scheme and other development projects in Bihar. The Prime Minister reiterated his assurance regarding the system of minimum selling price and said that it will continue unhindered. taking regularization of the serving daily wages before fresh recruitment in all the departments and implementation of Minimum Wage Act, Jammu and Kashmir Casual Labour United Front has announced a protest march to Governor House at Srinagar on September 23rd to press for their demands. Talking to media persons, the front leaders highlighted the grievances and demands of the casual workers who have been serving various departments since years but not getting even regular wages. Senior army commanders of India and China on Monday held talks on implementing a five-point agreement reached between the two countries on disengagement of troops and de-escalation of the tense situation in eastern Ladakh. The sixth round of corps commander-level talks began at around 9 a.m. in Moldo on the Chinese side of the line of actual control across India's Chushul sector in eastern Ladakh. The team also included a joint secretary-level officer from the Ministry of External Affairs. A women fighter pilot of the Indian Air Force will soon join the Golden Arrow squadron operating the newly inducted Rafale fighter jets. The women pilot is undergoing training to fly Rafale aircraft. She has been flying MiG-21 fighters and was selected for the Rafale fleet following an internal process. At present, the IAS has 10 women fighter pilots and 18 women navigators. The total strength of women officers serving in the IAF is 1,875. India has crossed the significant landmark of more than 80% national recovery rate of COVID-19 cases, the highest in the world by registering over 90,000 recoveries for the third successive day. At least 93,356 patients were discharged in the last 24 hours. The total recovered cases are close to 44 lakh so far, which is highest in the world. According to the Health Ministry, the recovery rate was 27.52% on May 4th, while it was 63.2% on July 13th, and on September 21st, the recovery rate has reached 80%.